Hello, I'm Wenling Zhu from Materials Characterization Lab of Penn State University. I will talk a little bit about Vanderpoel method, commonly used for measuring resistivity and Hall coefficient of materials. Vanderpoel method was first presented by L.J. Vanderpoel in 1958, which aiming for the resistivity and the Hall coefficient measurement of flat thin sheet sample with arbitrary shape. There are some sample requirements for using this method, which include user need to have a thin sheet sample, two-dimensional, better to be a film. The sample should be homogeneous and has uniform thickness without any isolated holes. The electric contact needs to be sufficiently small and located at the circumference of the sample. When measure arbitrary shape sample, a geometry factor F is used to improving the measurement accuracy. For eliminating external error, we always recommend to use a square shape sample if it's possible. Before Vanderpoel measurement, only contact check need to be done first. User will need to check every pair of contact, like 1 to 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 1 in the schematic to see if they all show linear relationship between applied current and the measure voltage, like the IV graph showing here. It is very important that measurement current must be within the sample's ohmic region. For the resistivity measurement as shown in the schematic, user needs to apply current along each rim of the sample and measure voltage reading from the rim facing to it, and then reverse the current direction, measure it again. To repeat this measurement process for all the rims of the sample square, we can subsequently get the resistivity of the sample under different measurement geometry by using the equation list here, and then take the average value as the final answer. Beside the resistivity, user also can use this method to get sheet resistance and conductivity of the sample. Vanderpoel method also very efficient for Hall effect measurement. As we all know, when a charge carrier like a hole moving into the sample drawn by the external current, like this, if there is a magnet field perpendicular to the sample surface, which showing in the schematic the magnet field point up, the hole will move towards the right upper corner of the sample due to the combined effect of moving velocity and the Lorentz force. This phenomenon is called Hall effect. When ending a perpendicular magnetic field voltage between 2 and 4 or 1 and 2 can be measured with applying a current through 1 to 3 and or 2 and 4 respectively. Please be aware that you also need to do a current and magnetic field reverse to finish the measurement. Hall voltage is average value of diagonal voltage measured under different measurement geometry. And the Hall mobility can also be calculated according to these equations. Beside the Hall voltage and the Hall mobility, user also can get carrier type, Hall coefficient, carrier concentration, etc. from the measurement process. In ECL, we have three system can performance Vanderpoel measurement. They are Ecopia HMS 3000, Lecture System, Keithley 4200 SCS. Here are the system capabilities include current range, voltage range, temperature range, magnetic field range, and the measurable resistance range. To summarize my tutorial, user can obtain bunch of different physical parameters of their sample like sheet resistance, resistivity, conductivity, Hall voltage, carrier type, pore coefficient, pore mobility, carrier concentration, bulk concentration. Compared to other method, the advantages of Vanderpoel method is can be used for arbitrary shape sample. It's a very efficient way for resistivity and hole measurement. Only requires very simple sample preparation and the measurement process. But it still has its own limitation, like user will expect to have a lower accuracy if their sample is non-homogenic, with non-uniform thickness, discontinuous, has isolated holes, or have no obvious ohmic behavior. Thank you.